Hello and welcome back to my channel. So today's video is going to be about creating this Valentine's Day card using certain vector elements and text. In our first step, we're going to try and create these flowers and leaves, etc. And then we're going to arrange it into a form and then put in text in here. So if you do want to learn how to create these elements, you can always go ahead to my blog and download the Illustrator file. It'll be something like this, which has all the elements in it. So if you click on them, you can individually select them and then you can arrange it and however you want. So let's first start with creating these elements that we have right here. Let's start by creating a new document. Go to File, New. Let's choose a custom file size for this. Let's make the width as 10 inches and the height as around 7, because normally your A4 size paper is about 11.5 inches into 8 point something inches. And you do want to leave a little space, bit of a space around so that you can use your trim marks to cut it. So let's make it 10 into 7 inches. And then bleed, let's make sure it has a 0.125 bleed. If you cannot see that setting, you can also go to More Settings and then choose your bleed right here. And then make sure your color mode is CMYK and raster effects is set to 300 ppi. And then let's click Create. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is we're going to create a background. You can go ahead and select your rectangle tool. You can also press M on your keyboard to do that. Now click and make sure you click at the whole board right here. We are covering the bleed marks as well. And now let's color this to one of our colors that we have specified earlier. I'm going to leave the links to all the colors and also tiny JPEG, which has all the colors so that you can go ahead and pick it up directly using your eyedropper tool. So let's make this dark, almost bluish gray. And now let's go to our layers and lock this up because we don't want to move this layer around anymore. Now let's go ahead and click on this button right here, which says new, create new layer. So here we're going to start working on all the elements that we have right here. If you don't want to know how to create these elements, you can skip to this timestamp. I'm going to place it right somewhere right here. I'm just going to create a new artboard here so that we have some space. Okay, now let's create this first one. So go to your pencil tool and it's an eraser tool now, right click and then you can go to pencil tool or plus N on your keyboard. So I'm just gonna make something like this, the stroke color edges, and turn this in to make the fill. But I want it to be this color. And as you can see it here, this is a gradient. So let's go ahead and make this gradient. Go to your selection tool, click on this. So now go to your gradient tool right here. If you cannot find this, you can find it in window and gradient. So let's click on, we want a linear gradient right here. We also want to change the color. So double click on this and you should have your colors over here. If that is when you pick the colors, you can get it right here. To get the colors in your swatches, what you can do is you can just download the JPEG file that I'll be attaching and bring it into your Illustrator. And then you can use your eyedropper tool. Let me just show you an example. So, okay. So now that we have these colors, go to your eyedropper tool, which is like you can press I on your keyboard. I can just click on this. Now you just click on the color. It could be a JPEG image as well. Just click on this. And then you go to your swatches and just click on new. And then click OK. And then you can see that color over there. So again, go ahead and click on this color. This is selected. So go ahead and click on this color. Go to new. Click OK. So this is how you get colors into your swatches if you want to. Let me just delete this. Coming back to the petal, now go back to your gradient tool and double click on this slider and go ahead and choose the color that you want. I think it was this one. The thing is, I want the gradient to be centered something like this. So I'll go ahead and click on my gradient tool. And when you come closer to this, you can move these up and down. And you can also kind of, you get this round button so you can twist it around as well, so something like this. And now as you can see, this is the dark blue here, this is the lighter blue here, so this is how it looks. But we want the opposite, so I'm just gonna bring it here and bring this all the way up and this down, and then let's keep it here Okay, so we have the gradient ready, as you can see here. And now we'll make these green little parts right here. And you can do that by getting on your pencil tool and just drawing in something like this. And let's color that. Make sure the ends are joined, so you can just click and drag on it so that it gets selected. And then go to your color swatches that you have already and click on that. Okay, so that's how I created all these things, and then I added a twig with the pencil tool again. So click on the pencil tool and draw a line and make sure the stroke is this color again. So that's how you create this flower, and I just arranged, made some few of them, and then I grouped them together to make one single point. So the next one, this one is actually just a pencil tool, and I just drew some twigs and made them look like this. I just randomly drew some twigs with my pencil tool, and I made sure the color is changed to that one. So coming back to these leaves over here, so I created a brush which actually paints like this. So to do that, what you can do is you can go to your ellipse tool first. Let's click and drag and make an ellipse. Now let's color this something like this and make sure the stroke is turned off though. Click to your anchor point tool. If you cannot find it, right click on anchor point tool. And now let's go ahead and click on the corners so that it forms a leaf kind of structure right here. Now select it and now open your brushes. You can go to window and brushes. So click and drag and drop and select art brush, click OK. And over here, we're gonna change some settings, make this 50% and the width, okay? And then method is, let's make it hue shift. You can choose this as hue shift if you wanna apply a gradient or if you wanna change the outer color and stuff like that. So click OK. So now if you go to your brush tool and select that brush and try to draw something, you kind of get that nice leafy kind of a thing. So that's how I created these and these leaves out here. So coming back to this flower right here, this was created exactly like this. The only thing is the pencil shape is completely different from what we have here, and it does not have a gradient. So this one, I used ellipses to create this. So let's just try to make this. Click on your ellipse tool, click and drag to make a ellipse. And let's make it fill, and let's change the color to something pink. Make sure this is like lighter pink because you have a darker pink in the background. So now go ahead and say Control C to copy, Control F to paste on top. And now we're gonna rotate it. So click on your rotate tool, or you can right click and select it. And now you see this blue thing right here? We're gonna move it to the corner and then click and drag somewhere over here. And now we're gonna take Control C and Control F, and now move this back to here and click and drag to make one over here. So next we're gonna modify this a little bit. Go to your direct selection tool and let's just click on this and try to make it a little thinner. You have to double click on it if you want to select it. So you can use these handles to modify it as well, like this. Now I want the petal in the background, but for this I used my pencil tool, and I just drew a ellipse right here, and I colored it something darker, something like this. One more, and these two I sent it to back using Command Shift and open square bracket. So yes, this is a little lighter here, so let's make it darker. Let's just choose the color from here. Okay, so that's how I created these petals right here. And then I created these things using my pencil tool again, the same way I did for this one right here. as you can see it. Moving ahead to this one was also created using pencil tool. I basically used pencil tool for everything else, and that's how I created all these elements. So once you have all these elements created, let's go ahead and try to arrange it into a very nice format right here. But before we do that, we have to kind of divide this page into two equal sections. So let's go ahead and view our ruler, view rulers and show rulers. So now we know that our document is 10 inches wide. So we're gonna bring our guides right in the center. To do that, just click on your ruler on the side and drag to bring in one guide, and let's place it right in the center at 5. Now all we can bring in our elements and try to arrange them over here. So let's go ahead and look at how I've arranged it right here. What I basically did was I just got in all the elements, resized some of them, and made some modifications to it. So let's just do that. I'll just select everything. Not everything. Obviously only this. Control C. And I'll go and paste it over here. I'm going to reduce the size by holding my shift key down. Okay. So let's just get started. Okay, so I've arranged everything right here, and you can basically rearrange the shapes and resize them. And as you can see, there's a yellow flower here, which I just used, I recolored this to get this one. So once you have all this ready, now it's time to put in text, and let's go ahead, I'll just lock this layer, go to new layer, and let's just type in love you. You can choose any text that you want, but for this is Arial Black. And I've set it to 100 points. So let's click on this center, align center, click on align, and click to align to artboard, and click on this. Now let's make this white. And you see there's a lot of space between both, so we're gonna go and change that. To do that, just click on paragraph, and then you see all these weird options right here. And one of the options that we need is this one. So if you click lower this, these kind of come together. Okay, that should be enough. Now we'll go ahead and align this again as to the center. Okay, so now it's time to overlap a few elements. You can actually use the same exact method that we used when we were trying to interlink texts. If you don't know how to do that, I'll leave a link somewhere over here to go check that video out. Now let's go ahead and unlock this layer, and we're going to bring in some element up, so lock the text layer. Click on the layer, and we want this somewhere, no, let's check this one. This one we wanted above a text, but we also want the O. So what we're going to do is just click copy, and let's click on the text layer, click again, and say Control F to paste it right on top. No. So let's lock this layer first and click on layer 4, say Control F to paste it right on top. So you can see this is how it looks like. But we want the petal only on U and not on O. So we're going to go ahead and bring our O as well. So let's lock the layer 4, go to your layer 3, click on your text, but you cannot move just O right now because it's text. So go to your type and click on create outlines. So now they are outlines, but you have to ungroup them first. Command, Shift, and G. So they are all ungrouped. Now you can click on O, Control C to copy it, lock this layer, unlock the layer 4, click on layer 4, and say Control F to paste it on top. So now you can see the petal is like kind of interlinking right here. You can do the same thing with other things as well. So for example, I'm just going to do this for V. Basically, you can do the same method as I just showed you, or you can also use divide function to create this thing. Okay, so now that we have all our elements ready, I'm just going to go ahead and delete this thing because we don't want it here. So this is locked, so I think it was on layer 2, so uncheck this, click and delete. Okay, so now the last step is to add some shadows to our text, like something like this, so that it pops out a little bit. So what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead over here and unlock our layers which have text in them. So let's just select this, and we're just going to click on the text and select the text. So hold your shift key down and click and select all the text that you have. Okay, now we can go to Effect, Stylize, and Drop Shadow. Click on Preview, and then make sure you check this setting to this one right here. Click OK. Click Outside, and you can see there's some kind of shadow right here. So yes, now that you added the shadows, now you need to save this file. So save this as an Illustrator file. You can press Command S to save the file, or you can also press File and Save and save it as an Illustrator file. Now we're going to save this as a PDF so that we can print it out. So go to your file, save a copy. Let's name it as 1. And here, change this to PDF. Click Save. Uncheck Preserve Illustrator Editing Capabilities. So what this does is it kind of reduces the file size, but you need to make sure that you save an Illustrator file before, because once you uncheck this, you won't be able to edit this PDF anymore. And I usually choose this as high quality print. And of course, uncheck this. Now go to your marks and bleeds and click on Trim Marks. And use document bleed settings. So it'll automatically choose what you have selected as bleed settings when we started working on this file. Click on Save PDF. Yes, okay. Now this file is saved. Let's go ahead and look at our PDF. Okay, so this is our PDF right here, and it has nice trim marks here. I will upload a copy of this PDF along with all the Illustrator elements, the color codes, and a JPEG file or Illustrator file which has all the colors in it, so that you can go ahead and download it from the blog. Thank you for watching, and I really hope you liked this video. If you did, please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. And by the way, happy Valentine's Day. So see you next week. Bye.